I'm Michael Surran. I work for Intermountain Rural Electric Association. Intermountain REA is one of the REAs that were started back in the 30s, so one of over 900. There's 22 in the state of Colorado. IREA is the largest in the state, and we're about the 11th largest in the United States. We have just over 200 employees, and we service over 150,000 consumers. Well, Intermountain's always prided itself on having extremely low outage hours. But unfortunately, over time, that cable that was put in the 70s and the 80s, things just started failing. It was not unreasonable to have a couple a year, but then it became a couple a month and then a couple a week, and almost to the point of having daily outages. So we knew we needed to do something. We tried looking at if a segment of cable has more than three faults, let's go ahead and replace it. Well, that was great for the first few, but then you realized we were getting lots of triple faults on the same segment, and replacing it is extremely expensive, especially in a well-established neighborhood where there's landscaping, people have everything just the way they want it, or if you're in a business area, parking lots are paved, it may or may not be in conduit, so we knew we had to look at something else, and that's when we started looking at cable injection. So when we started to do our injection of our URD cable, we had put together a crew. We had three guys, three linemen. They had a specialized van. We brought in special equipment, and they would go out and they would go to a neighborhood and systematically test all the cable. They would try to find the worst cable, and that was the cable we were injecting. Unfortunately, over time, we noticed that even though a cable may test well, when does it go bad? Is it going to go bad in a week, a month, a year? We really didn't know. And when it did go bad, now you were sending that same injection crew back to that neighborhood to do it. We did this for probably maybe 3-4 years, and we decided, look, if we're in that neighborhood anyway, let's inject all the cable. It's all the same age, it's all the same vintage, and we know for a fact it's gonna go bad. After we started injecting our URD cable, we started looking at our feeder cable. It was also having faults. Some of it was the same vintage as that cable in the 70s, and we decided that we needed to look further into it. At that point, we did start injecting our feeder cable. That helped out a great deal because a feeder cable, if that goes out, that just means way more consumers out of power, and we didn't want that. So if this was good for our single phase URD cable, it was definitely good enough for our feeder cable. In the beginning, we used the PUPR process, and that worked very well for us, and we cut down our outages greatly. But over time, we made the change to the SPR and IUPR process. For us, that was fantastic. With the PUPR process, we had 2.33% failure rate, and with this combination of the SPR and IUPR process, we cut it down to 0.6%. To date, Intermountain REA has injected over 2.5 million feet of cable. The cable injection process proved to be very beneficial to our company and our consumers. When we look back at the amount of cable that was injected, as well as what we were having faults on, and the age of that cable, the replacement cost would have been astronomical, in the hundreds of millions of dollars. So by injecting this cable, we save the company and our consumers tens of millions, if not hundreds of millions of dollars. So what I would recommend for other utilities is that you really do this injection process. In the beginning, I was a skeptic. I thought this was just some magic juice they put in the cable, we were gonna pay the money, we were still gonna have the faults, and that it would have been a waste of time and money. I was proved wrong. It worked very well. One thing I would suggest to companies is don't just do a pilot project. I know that's what a lot of engineering departments want to do, a lot of ops departments want to do, but the problem with that is you don't really see the benefits. You do too small of a pilot project and you don't notice it, the benefits you get from it. The process does work, but what you really need to do is look at overall injecting your entire system of your older cable. And don't just do one segment at a time, do a whole neighborhood. You're there anyway, your costs are lower if you go ahead and inject that whole neighborhood. Don't just do one segment and see if it fails. If it doesn't fail, you'll wonder, did it work or didn't it work? Would it have failed or would it have not? My suggestion to other utilities is to go ahead, use this injection process. It works well. Your consumers will be satisfied with it. Your operations department, engineering department will be happy with it. And overall, you'll save your system.